Hello everyone, welcome to my YouTube channel. In earlier chapters or earlier videos, we have learned to draw, edit and modify the sketches in Skeches. Now in this video we will learn to constrain, or how we are going to constrain the profile so that we can restrict their degree of freedoms to make them suitable. So for that process, generally the constraint toolbar is used. This is our constraint toolbar. So again, there are different types of commands are provided here. So first one is constraint defined in dialog box, second constraint, then fix together, animate constraint, and edit multiple constraint. So let us see here. Suppose I am using this profile. Draw a simple type of profile, any type of profile. Then suppose I want to make this line as a vertical, like this one. So we have to select this line, then go to the constraint define in dialog box. So click on the constraint define in dialog box. So in this dialog box, you can see there are the different types of options are provided with us. So distance, length, angle, radius, diameter, semi major axis, semi minor axis. But according to this line, only few options are open, like length, fix, horizontal and vertical. We need to convert this inclined line into vertical. So select a vertical line. So it shows a V symbol. V symbol, it shows a constraint definition. So click on OK. Again select this line. Suppose we need to convert this line into horizontal. So again select constraint toolbox, give it to the horizontal. So like this. This is H is indicate here horizontal, and it define as a parallelisms. Then click on OK. Then again, suppose I want to give the distance here. So click again the same line, give the constraint definition and length. So it shows the length here. Again click on the OK. Then again select these two lines. Again click on the constraint define in dialog box. So according to these two lines, how many chances of constraints we are providing there, it shows here. A distance, angle, fix, coincidence, parallelisms, perpendicular, horizontal. Suppose we need to provide it a parallelisms. So click on the parallelisms. So it shows a parallelisms. And again OK. Again. Suppose we need to provide a perpendicular dimensions between these two lines. So select again these two lines, go to the perpendicular. So this symbol shows here a perpendicular symbol. Now I'll just draw this circle. Now I want to use here this circle, and this line should be a tangent. So select this circle and this line as a tangency. Give it to the tangency. So you can see here, this is our tangency. Circle, this line is a tangency. Tangency. Again, like that, there are the different types of options: distance, length, angle, radius, diameter, or semi minor, major axis, symmetry, midpoint, equidistance, fix, coincidence, and many more options are provided with us. So let us see one by one. Suppose we have to provide a distance between these two is, so select these two and give the distance, the distance. Suppose we need to provide the angle between these two line, so select these two line and give the angle here. So this is the angle. angle between these two lines. So again click on the OK. Then again, if I am just drawing here an ellipse, and we have to give the dimensions to this ellipse. So major axis, semi major axis and semi minor axis. So click on the semi major axis and semi minor axis. Then OK. Just drag it to the dimension this one, like this one. Again, ellipse, provide the dimensions, semi major axis, semi minor axis, drag the dimension line to the outside, this way. Again, circle, and again suppose this is another circle, select these two circles, select constraint, do the concentricity, select this one. So both the center of both circles should be the same here, like this one. Again I want to make here a circle, next circle, select these two circles, should be a tangent, so give the tangency between these two, so automatically attach to each other. Again draw a circle, select these two circles and give it to the coincidence. So coincidence means both dimensions of the circle should be the same. So this is called as a coincidence. So we have seen the distance, length, angle, radius, diameter, then semi-major, semi-minor axis, symmetry, midpoint, equidistance, and all these are the constraint definitions. So these are very important point whenever we are going for the geometrical constraints. So we know that basically the constraint is provided by the different methods like our dimension constraining, and second one is geometrical constraining. Now second one is constraint. So give the select constraint and this will be dimension. So if you want to edit this dimension, just double click on the dimension and give it to 100, and you need to specify whatever the requirement, whether it is required a diameter or a radius. So we can convert it to radius or diameter according to our need, like this one. Again I am just using a simple rectangle here. Now again we have to use the symmetry of these two sides with reference to this horizontal and verticals. So select first line, then press control button, second line, and then select the horizontal line, then select the vertical line, first line, second line, and a vertical line, then select again constraint dialog box. So you can see a symmetry option is there, select this symmetry, click on OK. First line, control, second line, then horizontal, then symmetry. Then you can give the dimensions to this rectangle. Suppose this is 200, and again the length of this is 150. So you can see this color, it shows your green color, means this diagram is fully constrained. This diagram is fully constrained. Whenever we are going to draw any profile, so it is mandatory our diagram or profile should be fully constrained, right? So that is very important. So you can use this geometrical constraint and dimensioning constraining for the giving constraining to the profile, so which is very helpful to convert your diagram for 100% perfect. So this is related to our constraining toolbar. I hope that you like this session, and please subscribe my channel. And in next video we'll learn again some advanced module of our CATIA. Thank you.